Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live and Vibe show. We are living live. Dilla's not here today, so I'm going to be doing a one-woman show. Update on the missing...
...47 against Portland, but was it enough?
There's some heat on your way. You better keep cool.
On April 3rd, Christine Armstrong was participating in the Walk to Wave swim competition in Australia. Stay tuned for more details. Last month in Richmond, Texas, Captain Max's kids thought it was just an ordinary day on the baseball field, but it wasn't. Stay tuned for more details. That and so much more coming up shortly.
Don't have a yearbook or do you want to buy one to your friend? Well, we have a solution for you.
So talk to our school and raise money to purchase a yearbook. It's easy, just go to the link on my left and print the permission slip. Then turn it in to Mr. Porter in room 205 and he'll give you more information.
Welcome back. Now it's time for the Test Lot play-by-play. Friday kicks off our long-awaited spring break. Don't forget to not come to school. Enjoy your week off and classes resume on the 26th. We're at the halfway point to the entry deadline for the media festival. Hurry and submit your entries to room 205. It's now time for our gaming review with Matthew Lanto filling us in on the latest video games.
Hey guys, Matthew here, and today we have another game release. Today we have Bravely Default. Bravely Default is an RPG game for Nintendo 3DS, developed by Silicon Studio and Square Enix. The game's job and battle system are similar to Final Fantasy V. The story revolves around four young heroes of Luxendark. The wind vessel, Agnes, is obliged to confine the wind crystal consumed in darkness. The game was announced to be released in Europe and Australia in 2013, and in North America in 2014. There will also be a second sequel, Bravely Second, that was announced in December 2013. The game comes out on February 7, 2014. That is all the time we have for you today. We'll see you guys here next time.
For the play-by-play at Tesla, we're back right after the break. Australian authorities were confident that the signals came from the black box of Malaysian Airlines Flight 370 last Friday. Over the past weeks of searching, searchers found four pings detected by a ping locator. On Thursday, the fifth ping was located in the Indian Ocean. Australian authorities state that the fifth ping is unlikely related to the aircraft's black box. Friday marks 35 days for the search of the missing Malaysian Flight 370. On April 3rd, Christine Armstrong was participating in the Walk to Wave swim competition in Australia when she was snatched up by a shark. A local fisherman, Boya Djokovic, noticed that Christine went missing. He called the local police. Later that day, a friend of Christine noticed a large shark in the water that had a body figure in its mouth. The police later determined that the body found was indeed Christine Armstrong. Christine did not make it through the attack. Her family released a statement that, quote, she was a senior swimmer trying out for many years and that brought her much joy and many friends. She will be sadly missed, especially by Rob, her husband of 44 years, end quote. Shannon Jurgensen was traveling through Colorado driving 50 miles per hour on Highway 76 when all of a sudden a goose smashed into her windshield. Swerved like a spear on the steering wheel, it died from the crash. Thankfully, Jurgensen was uninjured and kept control of the vehicle. This hairdresser concluded, quote, I could barely see because the windshield was mangled. I turned my head, and when I opened my eyes, the bird was, its head just kind of fell over, end quote. She later uploaded pictures of this event online and called for help. She sustained no injuries, but she had a lot of glass in her hair. She was indeed a very This was indeed a very unusual event. Have you ever been surprised by your father? Last month in Richmond, Texas, Captain Ed Max's kids thought it was just an ordinary day on the baseball field. Their dad, who they haven't seen for years, surprised all his kids at the Lamar Little League field when he appeared. They were playing baseball. Their dad just finished his second tour in Afghanistan, but now he can stay with his family for a while. His 8 and 7-year-olds, along with 2 toddlers, are elated that they can spend time with their dad. Let's see what's going on in the entertainment world. Good morning, Alyssa. Thank you, Janiyah. The hit classic, The Giver, that was written by Louise Lowry, will soon hit theaters on August 15th. This new movie is about a young teen named Jonas who lives in a perfect community with the perfect family, school, friends, basically the perfect life. In this community, everyone must contribute something. If citizens help the community, they will be able to stay in the town, which is guarded by a huge gate. Nobody knows what lies beyond it. When someone in the community turns too old to contribute anything, they are taken and dropped off on the other side of the gate, not able to return. One day, Jonas is chosen by an elderly man to see what is beyond the gate and what the real world is. He realizes that his perfect community is fake and then confronted about his life and his future. This movie will star Brenton Thwaites, Alexander Skarsgård, and Taylor Swift. That's it for Live 5 Entertainment Report. Time to see what's going on in weather. Good morning, Isabel.
Thank you, Alyssa. Okay. So today in Los Angeles we'll have 76 degrees, San Francisco 72, and Seattle 68. Towards the middle of the country we have 46 Rapid City, 41 Denver, and 56 Albuquerque. On the other side of the country we have 72 Boston, 69 New York, and 75 Norfolk. Now for your 5-day forecast, sorry. Today we have 79 degrees, partly cloudy. Tomorrow 78 degrees, also partly cloudy. Pretty much all week partly cloudy. Wednesday 72, Thursday 73, and Friday 72. Now for your web pool with Dylan. Good morning, Dylan.
All right, thank you. Now today we have Faustina with us. Good morning. Can you please read our web pool for us?
What are you doing for spring break?
Here's what you said. Okay, well, I don't know what they say, but I'm just gonna be staying home, eating Cheetos. Shit. What are you gonna be doing for spring break?
I'm gonna stay home and watch a movie on Netflix.
Okay, thank you. Now we want to hear from you, so be sure to visit us online at 11.5show2vote. Send your comments to hashtag #LiveFivePoll, and we'll read it on the air. And now here's Johnny with sports.
Thank you, Dylan. In basketball, the Indiana Pacers beat Oklahoma City Thunder 102-97. Memphis Grizzlies beat Los Angeles Lakers 102-90. Portland beats Golden State Warriors in overtime 119-117. New York Knicks beat Chicago 100-89. And Brooklyn beats Orlando Magic 97-88. In baseball, the Dodgers beat Diamondbacks 8-6. Angels beat Mets 14-2. Giants beat their Rockies 5-4. And Athletics beat Mariners 3-0. In soccer, Hull City beats Sheffield United 5-3, Liverpool beats Manchester 3-2, and Chelsea beats Swansea City 1-0. For more news, Bubba Watson wins his second Masters in 3 years. Last week, NBA star number 7 for the Wizards, Al Harrington, injured his right knee with a torn meniscus and an infection. He will not be able to play for the rest of the season. It will take him 2 months or more to recover. He hopes that he will recover before then, because he wants to be able to play for the rest of the season. Running back Chris Johnson has been released from the Tennessee Titans. The news was announced via Twitter. Chris is now a free agent, which means any team can recruit him. On April 9th, a freshman by the name of Nick Tukas, decided to enter the NBA draft. He attended Michigan State University and is a star player of the basketball team. Many coaches and other players agreed with his decision to enter the draft. Coaches say that this is his rise of an upcoming star. Uska averaged about 17 points in a game. His college coach said that he would make a great impact in any NBA team he goes to. Last Thursday in basketball, the top play started with Gerald Green gets the pass from Goran Dragic and goes down the sideline to finish off the monstrous dunk. Next, Mario Chalmers gets the steal, runs from the court, goes up for the put. But last but not least, DeAndre Jordan gets the rebound after Matt Barnes misses a layup. DeAndre dunked a shot over 6'10" block, a 6'10" blocking machine, Serge Ibaka. DeAndre Jordan led the top plays for Thursday. Also last Thursday, the Dallas Mavericks played the San Antonio Spurs. The Spurs had their 9th straight win against the Mavericks and the 30th win on the road. Number 21, Tim Duncan, got frustrated with the referee call for a technical foul. He was then put out of the game. Even though Duncan, the Spurs found the way to defeat the Mavericks with the final score, 109-110 Spurs. That's it on sports. Time now with the Daily 411 Challenge with Janaya.
Thank you, Johnny. Okay. How many major islands make up Hawaii? 6, 7, 8, or 9? Tick 5. Eight. Hawaii consists of 8 major islands, Big Island being the largest. Can one still have hope after they lost their pet? Sassy in October 2000 was found 400 miles away from home. Cindy and Aaron Roman, the owners of Sassy, have been searching for their dog for a year and a half. Their dog was rescued by Forever Home Depot Rescue in Pittsburgh. They gave Sassy a foster home with April Smith and Hope Wilson, who were from Brentwood. After April received Sassy, she went to the vet and they checked Sassy for a microchip. They found Sassy's real owners and tried their best to find them. It took April Smith 17 months to get Sassy to her original owners. That wraps up the show for today. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Lion Pipe Show. We'll catch you back here tomorrow.